Pilot radio training for air traffic control is a huge part of flight school. Yet I hear some airline pilots on the radio and it makes me want to say,
shut up!
I'll explain to you how to improve for free. Coming up. Hey 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. So whether you're a pilot or an aviation enthusiast, consider subscribing. In this video, I'm talking about radio communication and radio phraseology, which is essentially how you speak on the radio. Now, if you decide to go to the airlines, about 50% of the flying you're doing is actually gonna be talking on the radio. Unfortunately, we don't spend a lot of time working on radio communication and radio phraseology, especially in the US. In this video, I'm gonna go over the two biggest errors that I hear pilots making on the radio and three ways which you can improve. Let's get into it. First, let's go over why it's important. First, if you're a new first officer that's showing up to an airline job and you are pushing back with a new captain, if in the first 15 or 20 minutes of flight, he's having to make radio calls for you because you can't properly speak on the radio or you're not able to properly handle the calls that are coming in, it is going to set a bad tone for you and it's going to make it a long 3 or 4 day trip if you're flying with that captain for all those days. So having that good radio phraseology is going to make just an easier work environment when you show up and you start working at the airlines. Second, another situation is if you're flying general aviation and you're asking for requests, meaning maybe cutting through a Bravo airspace, or if you're trying to get a favor from air traffic control in order to do something, if you're using good radio phraseology, air traffic control will feel you are more professional as a pilot and maybe willing to give you something that they will not give to a person that sounds like they're just trying to learn how to fly. So you may be able to get favors by speaking very well on the radio. The third point to consider why it's important to learn how to properly speak on the radio is if you leave the US or you leave your native country and you're flying overseas, you are gonna find that not every controller is gonna speak English very well and your English may have an accent. So if you're using unstandard phraseology while you're speaking on the radio, for example, you're a pilot from Argentina and you're flying from Argentina to Paris and you, once you enter France airspace, you're gonna both be speaking English, which is not your native language. In that scenario, you're gonna be both hindered a little bit in what it is that you're trying to communicate. If you're speaking a proper ICAO phraseology, it's going to prevent one, the possibility of an accident, and two, it's going to prevent possible delays that you could have because of miscommunication that's happening between the both of you. So those are the reasons why it's important to learn how to properly speak on the radio. Now let's address the two big errors that I hear pilots make on the radio. One is confusing two and four. And here's an example of that.
JFK departure Boeing 1, 8,400, climbing 2, 900,000. Boeing 1 JFK departure, you're climbing to flight level 290?
You see how that could be a problem? The pilot's thinking, I'm climbing to 9,000 feet. Air traffic control is maybe misunderstanding you climbing to flight level 290 because you're saying 290,000 feet. So using that 2 and using that 4 can be a problem. Here's an example of using 4.
Berlin departure Boeing 1, 3,400 for flight level 50.
Now I know some of you are making the argument, well, you said flight level and they should be able to distinguish that. And you know what? Yes, they should be. In a perfect world, that's exactly how it'd be. However, that's not the reality of the situation. You're gonna have some controllers who are gonna be weaker in English than others. So when you are saying four, flight level 50, they may be hearing flight level 450 or confusing the numbers. So just eliminate that possible confusion of what could be happening and that will increase your safety overall while you're out flying. So I'm gonna give you another example. I'm gonna put in a clip here. I was just recently on a flight and I was watching Miami Vice, which is a pretty cool movie. In it, Jamie Foxx is flying and he's flying and he's about to do an ILS. And I was listening to him and I thought, that's how a lot of guys speak on the radio. So he's actually doing it correct as far as how pilots are often speaking on the radio, but it's not proper ICAO phraseology. So watch this clip.
Approaching Dachau, turning to heading 340 down to 6,000 feet. Clear through the Irish runway 10 for the approach port of France.
So you see how that could be confusing? If English wasn't your native language, you could be confusing what flight, what altitude is he going to, what he's doing the ILS to what runway? Things like that, those small things could be issues on a bigger scale. So it's important to get in those good habits now of speaking correctly. The second biggest issue that I hear from pilots is using slang when they're on the radio. And again, in the US, most air traffic control are gonna know what you're saying. However, getting into those bad habits, especially early on in your career, are gonna make them harder and harder to stop as you get later on. So it's important to develop those good radio habits now, so later on in your career, you're not having any problems with it. Here's an example of one that I hear sometimes on the radio.
Boeing 1, Denver Center. Traffic 10 o'clock, 3 miles, 1,000 feet above. Denver Center, Boeing 1. Yeah, we got him on the fish finder.
If you're wondering what the face of the air traffic controller you're talking to is looking like, it looks something like this. Now here's another example of slang I used to use when I was flying at the regionals and when I was doing charters. It was a bad habit that I got into. And before I started flying 747s, I knew that it was gonna be a bad habit, but this is a bad habit that I had had for several years. So when I showed up on my very first flight of the 747, the captain asked me to get the clearance. I called, I got the clearance. And when I read back the clearance, I read back the IFR clearance like this. Departure frequency 120.5, and 1234 in the box. And obviously in the US, we know in the box means that's gonna be your squawk code. And what it should have sounded like was departure frequency 120.5, squawk 1234. Anyway, when I read back that clearance, I could see the captain was looking at me and I looked over at him and he says, do you think that they're gonna know what you're saying when you say in the box in another country? And I said,
bitch.
No, it's not what I said. I just said, okay, yes, sir. And that was it. And I knew that I had made that mistake. I knew that wasn't proper phraseology, but it was a bad habit. Breaking those bad habits early on are gonna make it a lot easier as you get further and further in your career. Here are two ways to improve. One, if you're a new pilot and you're in flight school, first, don't set yourself up for a standard of perfection on the radio. I still make errors. There's a lot of pilots that make errors, so don't beat yourself up on it. But just work on being conscious about trying to improve your phraseology. The first thing I would do, especially if you're a new pilot, is start listening to online websites like ATClive.net or sites like that that have air traffic control. Go to a busy airport, go to JFK, go to LaGuardia, Newark, go to LAX, Dallas, any of those busy airports and start listening to what those air traffic controllers are saying and then listen to the pilot's response. It's important to listen to the controllers because generally controllers are speaking with proper phraseology. So if you listen to what the controllers are saying and you repeat back in the way that they're saying it to you, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna be able to speak in proper IKO phraseology. So it makes it pretty easy, monkey see, monkey do. But sometimes you'll hear pilots, including airline pilots, on the radio, and they're using 2 or 4 or other slang words while they're talking. And if you listen for that while you're listening to the radio, it gives you something to focus on for yourself and a way for you to improve, because now you're listening for what are the controllers saying, and you can practice in the comfort of your home or in your car or wherever you're listening to it, you can practice doing those things. If you've seen my video on passing check rides, you remember I was talking about chair flying. This is kind of the same thing. If you're learning how to talk on the radios while you're also learning how to fly a plane, it can get overwhelming. Practicing doing these radio calls when you're not also flying a plane makes it easier. And like everything in aviation, the more you practice, the better you're gonna get. The second thing you can do is online, you're gonna find PDFs on ICAO phraseology. Some of them are free. Again, ICAO, I-C-A-O, ICAO phraseology. There's tons of PDFs online. Some of them have errors in them, but they're free. So it's a good way to start reading and improving on your communication. Another book, which is one that I have, and I'll put a link to it up here, Everything Explained for a Professional Pilot. Now, it's not a mandatory thing that you need to read, but it is something, I think when I had about 300 or 400 hours, I got it and started reading it. It goes over radio communications and a lot of other things that you should consider. So that's another option, and it's not free, but it's definitely something that you can do to improve on your overall skills as a pilot, because it's not just flying. Like I said, 50% of your time flying is gonna be not flying. So it's important to start improving on those skills early and develop those good habits. So that's all I have on radio communications. In the comments below, let me know what areas of radio communications you wanna improve on. Just generally being more comfortable on the radio? Do you wanna improve on your radio phraseology? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a like and a thumbs up. Make sure to share it with a pilot that needs to improve on their radio communications or that wants to improve on their radio communications. I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.